on the February 15th, immediately after Valentine, I received a very distressing call. And the call was from a doctor in America for the situation, and the message is distressing in that the doctor just called and finally said, "Hey, are you Steven?" "Yes." "So, do you know this lady?" "Yes." And apparently that was my girlfriend there. And what they said is that, you know, she's dead and you need to come and see her in the hospital before she gets ferried back to their country. So, before I get into the details of what the vision is really all about and what the vision is about, it's really important to understand where we came from. So that we came from a place where this lady had received, had been having minor strokes. Minor strokes is whereby the brain gets like a shortage of blood and your bodies get paralyzed and then you can kill back. So every time she had these minor strokes, her family would tell her that she's being targeted and it's the cases of witchcraft and things like that in the community. So when she finally died of stroke, which had already started manifesting like 2 years ago in the form of minor strokes, and the family didn't take care of her, then it dawned to them that then this is a big problem. 2 years later after that, my aunt died of cancer, not because her family was not able to take care of her, but because they were misinformed. They had the wrong ideas of what cancer is about, so that when she had these alarms on her breast, what they say is that she's being targeted, and that they took her to the herbal doctor, the herbal doctor, and to get her well and that in proper shape. So that forms one of the biggest problems which we intended to target at Sterling, which is the problem around sensitization awareness and uncommunicable diseases. So uncommunicable diseases in largely in developing countries has three big problems. So one is the generation before us is misinformed. They have the wrong information about non-communicable diseases, and most of that is contributed to the fact that when they were growing up, they had this active lifestyle, so there were very rare cases of these diseases. And then the next thing is that the generation now, the youth, the 18 to 35s, they don't anymore actively engage in making conscious health decisions about their health. And this is also majorly contributed by the fact that we have changed from an active lifestyle to a sedentary lifestyle where everybody is on their phone and fast food is the end of the day. And another problem which we target on addressing is unemployment in youth. So what is Sterling? Sterling is a youth-driven organization whose end goal is to see that there are better, healthier communities and that there's employment for the youth. So our solution around this problem is that we decided to go to the communities because we had seen the gap. And for me, it was a personal touch that caused the reawakening because I had experienced it firsthand. So we had seen the gap in uncommunicable diseases, and we acknowledged that the government in our country, and probably this is between many countries, have really addressed non-communicable diseases. And in this place, I mean diarrhea, HIV, AIDS, malaria. The government has really tried to address that, and it has forgotten about non-communicable diseases, diabetes, obesity, fistula, cancers, heart diseases. So when we identified this gap in information and ultimately in service provision, we decided that we need to do something about it. So we had to be innovative around a service and rather than a product, which was said. So what we decided to do is that we decided to do projects in the community. So we've had projects like Project Alpha on cancers, My Heart KD on cardiovascular diseases, and these several other projects whereby my team would go down there in the communities to the elderly and assemble them, talk to them, teach them about health. And when we were to get out of those communities, we left like ambassadors who would constantly remind the community about health and well-being and stuff like that. And we identified focal people in the community to act as the people who would act as ambassadors. So that really helped us tackle the problem of sensitization and awareness and getting people right information, but not only right information but in a relevant way which they can actually understand. Then we also had a very big problem around how do we actively engage the youth in health, because When we did our first project, which was Project Alpha on Cancer, and had reached over 500,000 people over 3 months with these messages, well, the next big question was, okay, now the youth know about cancer, for example, but how do you maintain them here? How do you ensure that they learn about health and that they have relevant information about health? So that is where we decided to solve this other problem, which was unemployment in youth. So what we did is that we decided to bring youth on board and bring them to a training session so that to bring them to a program which I'll talk about later on how we could keep them on board. Our target market really is the millennial youth, adults, professionals, and Android phone users. So, and the reason why Android phone users are our major target is that we have a mobile application on Play Store, which has all the relevant information on non-communicable diseases in a way that is easily understandable. And the catch about the mobile application, and I talk about it in a few, is that you can freely consult with a medical doctor or a practitioner online. And when you are diagnosed to be having a problem or something like that, you can be able to refer you to our partners, which are hospitals and institutions handling these cases, so that when you are referred from a mobile application, you get to be treated at subsidized costs, or you get to be diagnosed at subsidized costs, so that you get there. If you go there with a code which is sent to you from the app after the consultation, and you present it to our focus person in these institutions, we refer you to, you get treated at subsidized costs. The impact we've had so far is that, and this is before May. This data is before May this year, and we've been able to reach 1.2 million people with messages on communicable diseases. In Kenya, we've traveled through what I'd say here is provinces, like 5 major provinces, which all 5 major cities, going deep down in the communities to talk about these messages. We've held several training or trainer sessions, visited schools, visited communities, and